Hello everyone, myself Priya Shah from Department of Pharmacognosy at LJ Institute of Pharmacy. Today we are going to discuss herbal formulation. What is herbal formulation? Herbal formulation means a dosage form having one or more herbs. Herbs can be available either in a raw form or in a processed form. What is raw form? Raw form means a powder form. And what is processed form? Processed form means while herbs are subjected to the different processes like maceration, percolation, distillation, extraction, expression. Herbal formulation contains a herbal substances or in a combination of herbal preparations like tinctures, dry extract, wheat extract or oil extract. Now, there are different purposes for the preparation of herbal formulation. First is it provides in nutritional and cosmetic benefits. Second one, it reduces or in a treatment of disease for a human beings or animals. Third one, it alters the structure or physiology of human beings or animals. Now there are two types of dosage form. One is traditional dosage form. Second one is novel dosage form. The examples of traditional dosage form, that is syrup, tablets, capsules, powders, mixtures. Now, example of novel dosage form, the phytosomes, liposomes, microspheres. Now, here there are different types of herbal formulation, tablet, capsules, suppositories, transdermal patches. Now, first, we will discuss the traditional formulation. In traditional formulation, here we are discussing the syrup. What is syrup? Syrups are aqueous preparations having a sweet taste and viscous consistency. They mainly contain aqueous solution of sucrose, having 67.7% weight by weight of sugars, as per USP having 85% of weight by volume of sugars. Now, syrup mainly used as a sweetening agent, as a preservative, as a flavoring agent, or used as a blend. Now, there are three types of syrup. First one is simple syrup, second one is medicated syrup, and third one is flavored syrup. What is simple syrup? Simple syrup means the sucrose is dissolved in a hot water, that is known as simple syrup. Simple syrup mainly used as a vehicle. Second one, that is medicated syrup. Medicated syrup mainly used for the therapeutic purpose. And third one is artificial syrup. Now, method of preparation of syrup. There are two methods which can be employed for the method of preparation of syrup. First method, that is solution with heating. Second one, that is agitation without heating. As solution with heating, in that method heat is applied. That means it is applicable only for the thermostable material as well as for non-volatile phytoconstituent. In this method, first sucrose is dissolved in water, then heat it, strain it, and lastly you have to make up the quantity. Second one method, that is agitation without heating. In this method, it is applicable for only for the heat sensitive material or volatile material. Now, in this method, mechanical agitators are used. Now, different components of syrup. First component is sweetening agent. As a sweetening agent, here we are using sucrose or sugar. Second one, that is antimicrobial or preservatives, methyl paraben, propyl paraben, sodium benzoate, which can be used as an antimicrobial or preservative. Third one is viscosity modifier, hydroxyethyl cellulose, which can be used as a viscosity modifier to increase the viscosity of syrup. Fourth one, that is the chemical stabilizer, is a chemical stabilizer, sorbitol, glycerin, which can be used. Next one, coloring agent. In coloring agent, coltar dyes like amaranth, then tartrazine, compound tartrazine. Now last one is flavoring agent. In flavoring agent, different flavors are used like vanilla flavor, strawberry flavor, then lemon tincture, ginger tinctures. Now we will discuss advantages and disadvantages of syrup. First, here we will see advantages. What are the advantages of syrup? First advantage, it acts as an antioxidant. Second one, it acts as a preservative because of high concentration of sucrose. Third one, it having good patient compliance. Fourth one, that is by using flavoring agent we can mask the taste. Fifth one, that is used for the children, or this formulation can be appropriate for the any age of the patients. Now disadvantages. First disadvantage is due to the high concentration of sucrose, there may be chances of crystallization. Second one, having the delay onset of action because we can't avoid the first pass metabolism. Now we will see the evolution parameter of herbal syrup. First evolution parameter is determination of physical constants. In physical constant, we have to check the pH, total solid content, specific gravity and viscosity. Second one parameter, that is the phytochemical screening. In phytochemical screening, we have to evaluate the different phytoconstituents by performing the chemical test. Third one is the quantitative estimation of the phytoconstituents. Fourth one method, that is the heavy metal analysis. Fifth one, that is the microbial contamination or microbial load analysis. Sixth one, HPLC. Next one parameter, that is stability testing. Now next, that is novel dosage form. Why novel dosage form is used? Due to the limitation of traditional dosage form, novel approach is used as a novel dosage form. Now there are different advantages of novel dosage form. First advantage is it enhances the solubility and pharmacological actions. We can reduce the dose of the formulation. Third one, increase the bioavailability. Fourth one, sustained drug delivery system can be obtained. And it protects from toxicity or degradation of chemical and physical components. Now there are different types of herbal novel dosage form. First is liposomes, second phytosomes, microspheres, nanoparticles, microemulsions. Now here we will discuss the phytosomes as a novel dosage form. What is phytosomes? Phyto means a plant and zome means a cell-like structure. This is advanced form of herbal formulation in which the bioactive phytoconstituent of herbal extract surrounds and bounds by a lipid. As a lipid, phosphatidylcholine or soya lecithin can be used. Now, most of the bioconstituents are water soluble. For an example, flavonoids or glycosides which can be used. So, it is easily bound by the lipid. So, due to the reaction, we can increase the bioavailability. Now, method of preparation of phytosomes. In this method, the phytosomes are prepared by reaction of phospholipids with the phytoconstituent in a different proportion. 1:1, 1:2 or 3:2 moles used. Now, there are three methods for the method of preparation of phytosomes. First method, anti-solvent precipitation method. Second one method, rotary evaporation method. Third one method, that is solvent evaporation method. Now here we will discuss a common method of preparation of phytosomes. First we have to take the active constituent of herbal drugs, which is water soluble. Second one, we have to take phospholipids. As a phospholipid we can take soya lecithin or phosphatidylcholine. Now mixed in a aprotic solvent. What is aprotic solvent? Aprotic solvent means there is no OH or no NH bond is there. Now we have to mix in a mixture or in a rotary bottom flask, round bottom flask, and with a constant stirring. Complex is formed that we have to take into organic solvent, dissolve this complex into organic solvent, so it will form a thin film that is known as phytosomes. Now here we will discuss the difference between phytosomes and liposomes. In phytosomes, a specific ratio is used. While during liposome formation, we required the specific ratio that depends upon the specific condition of the constituent. Phytosomes involves chemical bond. While here, no chemical bond is formed. Phytosomes having the high bioavailability compared to the liposomes. Now see the structure structural difference between phytosomes and liposomes. In first part, liposomes is explained, while in second part, the phytosomes is explained. What is liposomes? In liposomes, the water-soluble herbal drug is surrounded by the lipid layer. While in phytosomes, the water-soluble drug that is available in a form of triangle, that is entrapped in a lipid layer. Now here, there are advantages of the phytosomes. By phytosomes, we can improve the absorption, we can get better bioavailability, reduces the dose, better stability study, hepatoprotective synergistic effect. By hepatoprotective synergistic effect, we can get, because phosphatidylcholine used as a phospholipid, that having the hepatoprotective activity as such. Now, while in a preparation, if we are using the herbal drug that having the hepatoprotective activity, so due to phytosomal formulation, we can get the synergistic activity of hepatoprotective. Now, it is more biodegradable, high entrapment efficiency. Now, we will discuss the properties of phytosomes. Here, we will discuss two properties. One is chemical properties and second one is biological properties. In chemical properties, due to the presence of water-soluble constituent and phospholipid, there is a formation of hydrogen bond between the polar heads of phospholipids. Now, while we are taking into water, phytosomes assumes a micellar shape. Now, we will discuss the biological properties. Phytosomes are advanced form of the herbal products that are better absorbed, and due to better absorption, they having the high bioavailability. Now, evolution parameter of phytosomes. First one is determination of total yield or percentage yield. Second one, determination of size, particle size and size distribution. Third one is DSC. DSC is mainly used for the thermal analysis. Fourth one is SEM. SEM is mainly used for the identification of outer characterization or microscopical studies or outer appearance. Next one, that is percentage of drug entrapment. Next one, that is FTIR. FTIR mainly used for the identification of functional group. Last one is in vitro dissolution studies. Now we will discuss the application of phytosome. There are many examples available of the herbal drug in a form of phytosomes. Here we will discuss a few examples. First example, that is psilocybin phytosomes. Psilocybin, that is the phytoconstituent which can be isolated from the silymarin plant. Psilocybin phytosomes mainly used for the hepatoprotective purpose. Second one is ginkgo phytosomes. In ginkgo phytosomes, the flavonoids can be isolated from ginkgo plant, and these flavonoids are water soluble, surrounded by the lipid layer, so it can be used as an anti-skin aging agents. Third one is curcumin phytosomes. In curcumin phytosomes, the polyphenols which can be isolated from curcuma longa, and by preparation of phytosomes, it can be used as a cancer chemopreventant preventive agents. Next one is glycyrrhiza phytosomes. Glycyrrhiza phytosomes having the anti-inflammatory activity. Thank you so much for watching my presentation.